Hello and welcome to another Ye Olde Battle Report, and today me and Dan are going to be trying out a new game called Burrows and Badgers by Oathsworn Miniatures, which Dan picked up quite a while back now, about a year ago or so, and we just haven't got round to trying it out. So it's basically a game where you use various woodland creatures. It's a bit like Mordheim, like a skirmish game, and you can have skills.
It's kind of across the owner talks about it, it's a cross between Mordheim and Redwall.
Yeah, and if you see some of these models, are absolutely awesome. Yeah, you got like toads, bats, the badger, obviously, cats and otters and so on. So we've just made up a little warband for a test game that we're going to try out. A bit smaller than normal warband, and we're not going to be using all the rules. Like we're not using magic, but we're just going to give it a go and we'll film it.
Yeah, this is our test game really, so it's hopefully an opportunity for you to see the game and see how it works.
Yeah.
More than,
Yeah, and then we'll start a campaign at some point.
Yeah.
So yeah, let's get on with the game. These are all the models we've got for the game, but we're not using all these in the report. I think we've got four each for our warbands.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're doing an open battle, just the first one to rout, basically. Got my guys, I've got a wildcat, a toad, a shrew, and a black rat. The wildcat's my hero. He's got some extra abilities.
Which one got
a hero or just
leader?
Leader.
Okay.
And then Dan has got the badger, which is his leader.
Sparrow, squirrel, and dormouse.
Cool, so we've deployed like that, and Dan is going first, so he's just going to move up his badger.
So I've got a move of 8, but I'm not going to go that fast. I'm just going to move. I mean, 8 is as far as I like, so the badger basically going to come out to there.
Okay, so basically, it's the end of the first turn. We alternate activation for the models. I've just moved up my models because I've got no shooting or anything. Dan's badger and his. What's that again?
Squirrel.
Squirrel over there. The sparrow can fly really fast. It's come around here, and it doesn't actually say in the rules that it ignores terrain when it flies, but. At least we don't think it does, but we've just said that. Maybe it's in the FAQ or something. And his, what was that?
Dormouse.
It shot at my shrew, but it didn't do anything because my shrew's quite nimble. Okay, so Dan's going. Another thing which I'm not sure of is how going first works, because Dan won the initial roll off to go first. We think that just continues on to the subsequent turns. So the shrew is going to shoot.
No, this. Dormouse.
Sorry, the dormouse is going to shoot at the shrew.
They both got a d6.
Yeah. So you get a
3.
I get 5. So okay, so we're coming near to the end of the second turn. We'll just show you how we've moved. So the sparrow has come down here.
Circling around.
And I don't think I can really get him, so I'm going to.
But I don't know what I'm doing with him either.
No. He kind of needs a ranged weapon or a spell, doesn't he?
He doesn't need a ranged weapon or spell, yeah.
So I'm just sort of moved up. Round here, because basically in this game, if you charge from a long way away, you end up being really crap because you get massive penalty to your attacking score. So I've been a bit caged with that, but I've finally moved my wildcat up. Dan's going to charge with a badger, and he's got a special rule.
Yeah, he's got furious charge. He doesn't suffer any penalties. Yeah. I mean, he's only an inch away anyway.
Yeah,
so it wouldn't make no difference.
Yeah, it wouldn't make much difference.
I just want to get
the
badger into combat.
So the badger's going to charge a wildcat. Oh my god.
Right.
Okay, so Dan has to roll a D. What are you rolling?
D10. D10. Because
different size of animals and strength of animals use different type of dice, which I think is a really cool mechanic.
Yeah, it's a really fun way of doing it.
So the badger rolls a D10 to attack the cat, and I only roll a D6, which is still pretty good. Go for it.
I think you're fearsome, aren't you?
Fearsome, yeah, what does
okay.
that do?
Well, you. Yeah, you take a test, but I think because we're both fearsome, we won't do that.
Okay.
I think it doesn't say it in the rules again, but I think if we're assuming you're both fearsome, you don't take the test.
Yeah, it makes sense. Yeah.
I think there might actually be a fearless rule, but we'll go with that for this game because it's easier for the moment. So my D10 roll, 10.
10, so you get plus 7.
And plus 5.
So what's that going to be?
So 22 my score is.
Okay.
Because we didn't mention earlier, if you get the highest roll on the dice that you're rolling that you can, so a 10 or a D4 or 4, you add 7 to it. It's kind of introduces the element of luck.
A perfect roll.
A perfect roll, they call it.
So I need a perfect roll here. Oh, 5. Okay.
So you're 5. I think we'll have to work this out
yeah.
and come back.
Yeah. Okay, so because of that roll, basically, The cat's still alive, but basically that's as much as that badger could do, isn't it? That's like that, 22 wounds.
That is the best damage you can possibly do.
The cat's.
I mean, you could have rolled work. I mean, if you had rolled a 2 or something, you'd just be dead.
It'd be dead.
In one go, which is pretty ridiculous.
It's just a lucky roll.
It was a lucky
one
roll.
One in ten. Because the cat's tough, kind of, and it's got a heavy arm, it's still alive, it's got 2 wounds left, but it's now, which is another really cool mechanic, I think, because it's only got 2 wounds left, it's really weakened. It doesn't just carry on the same like in Mordheim. So it's got a -7 to all its,
tests.
Is that to all its tests?
Yes.
Wow. So it's not really going to do anything now because it.
No, I don't think it can.
Certainly not against the badger, so
no.
It'll probably have to go against. Well, I don't know what it can do now, but yeah. Fucking hell. I've still got my toad to go.
Yeah,
so because I can't get the sparrow, I move the toad up just to help out over here.
So you'll get an additional -1 to your block test.
Oh, right, when you engage with someone else. Dan's charging the squirrel in to the thing. You didn't measure how far it was. It was about 3 inches or so, wasn't it?
Oh, yes, it was. So he was actually, there, almost exactly on the edge of that bit.
Yeah.
So where's my tape measure gone?
We just use the inch measurements on that. Yeah.
So 3 inches. Yeah. So -3, he's going to get to his strike attack. Cool. And you get -7.
-7. So he's probably going to die.
-8 in fact, because you're outnumbered.
To the squirrel.
Well, you're tough at that. Depends. If I roll on 1,
you get a perfect roll. Yeah. Maybe.
So I get 4. So my roll is 1. What's your block?
Because I've got tough 1 and heavy armour. So.
Yeah, what's your block skill?
D6
as well, okay.
1. Okay,
so you've got a score of -7.
Yeah, my strong and tough and my tough and heavy armor will still not be enough to keep me alive.
Keep you alive. Yeah,
yeah, so the cat will die.
Yep. Squirrel just gets to stab the cat in the back, basically.
Okay, so my toad has charged the
squirrel.
Yeah, so it's it was just over 2 inches, and what we're saying is that if it's more than 2 inches, that counts as 3. Is what we've done. Kind of the only thing that makes sense to us, but he's strong 1 anyway, and he's got a double-handed weapon, which is his bone. So
that's significantly larger than the bone of any animal in this kingdom. So
I'll cancel that charge out. Actually, so we're just rolling straight dice.
Yeah.
His strike value is D6.
D4.
So I've got a 5.
I've got a 1.
Okay, so
he basically 1 by 4.
4. Suffer 4 wounds.
4 wound.
Yeah, not bad. I doubt the badger will kill him unless he's really lucky, because all animals in this have 16 wounds.
Yeah.
And how they differentiate how hard to kill they are is by having things like tough, which minuses minus the number of wounds.
Yes. So if you've got tough 3 and you suffered 3 wounds, you suffer no wounds.
Yeah.
And my badger is tough 5.
Yeah.
Because you've got tough 3 and heavy armour, which is an additional tough 2, and it's cumulative.
Yeah. Cool. Okay, so it's Dan to go next. Okay, so your Dormouse is going to shoot my rat. Okay. So it's just a d6 each. 3. 4. So nothing.
Not been good at shooting this guy. I just stood there just missing.
Okay, I've charged in the black rat against the squirrel over there. The black rat's a bit better of a worry than the toad, so he's got D8.
Squirrel's going to have an additional -1 because of the wound he suffered.
Yeah, D8, but I did have to charge 4 inches to get there. So my score is a 4.
And mine is 2. 2 minus 2, so my score is 0.
But mine would be 0 as well, because I charged 4 inches.
Okay, so nothing happens.
I should have left a gap, really, for this other guy to get in. Okay, the sparrow has flown from over here into the fray. But obviously can't charge anyone from that distance. It still can fly a long way, but it can't charge into combat very far away. Okay, I'm going to charge my shrew against the sparrow. So, turn him around to face me. And my strike is D6. So.
And my sparrow D4, and I've got a shield. I've got a tough 1.
Oh, 1. And that would be -3 anyway. So nothing. Really. Yeah, nothing.
Okay. Time for the badger. Badger.
Can charge a toad?
Yep.
Yeah, it doesn't get any penalties for charging.
No. Nope. Yep. And you get -1 because you're outnumbered.
Yep.
So I'm on a d10.
toad block is... Oh, only d4 for the toad, shit.
You might get a perfect roll.
Yeah, it makes it more likely to get a perfect roll, yeah. Okay.
So I've got one. Which still counts as six. One. So you've got tough two?
Tough two.
Okay, so so my score is six.
Mine's three, so be take 3 wounds.
3 wounds, yeah.
Okay, so we turn three now, so the badge is just going to go again and attack the toad again. See if we can get a better roll this time.
Six. You need a perfect roll here. You need a four.
I get minus one because I've suffered 3 wounds. That takes me to the first penalty point.
And you're
point,
at so. Minus two.
Minus two. Shit. Three. So it becomes so one.
So my score is 11.
My score is three.
So you take 8 wounds.
Wow. Okay, so really, I'm going to go with my rat to do some more wounds to the squirrel, so hopefully it can't kill the toad. And this time I've got I'm charged, so I'm getting no minuses, and Dan will be minus two because his wounds are outnumbered.
Yep.
So d8, come on, let's get an 8 here. 8!
Oh, I need a perfect roll here. 1.
So my score is
minus 1.
My score is 8 plus, so 15 plus. Is my score.
15. So it's actually 16, you actually add 1 because of minus 1, so my score
16. Is just kills a squirrel. Yep. Nice.
Oh, that's sad.
Cool. And you've got
Sparrow
and
Dormouse.
Useless Dormouse over there.
Yeah, he's done this follow so far.
Okay, Sparrow versus Shrew.
Sparrow versus Shrew. It's like a name I'll never say in my life. So I'm D6.
Yep.
One. What's your
and
block?
The Shrew's block is 4.
You got a shield as well?
Oh shit. Yeah, I've got a shield actually. Okay. What does that do?
I haven't attacked you yet, so. It's a tough one.
Oh, cool.
So basically, any roll you get, if you get one, you don't have any wounds.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I can't fail on
you
that.
You can't fail
it, yeah. Okay, let's just go with the toad.
And hope for a perfect roll, basically.
Yeah, the toad's taking quite a lot of wounds. Okay. So the toad has got a double-handed weapon, though, so it's a strong one. Be minus one to minus four, but plus three. Because of strong one and double handed weapon.
Yeah.
So be minus one basically.
That's not too bad.
Yeah.
Too bad. My block skill's pretty poor, it's only 4.
Okay, so we want a 6 really on this. Two. So,
4.
No,
4. No. So I've got the highest one, I've got 11.
Yeah, so nothing. Cool, okay. And you're just going to shoot with your Dormouse.
Yep, I'm going to shoot the red. Again. So I've got minus one for this because you're partially visible.
Yeah.
6.
Oh, shit.
So that's 13, minus 1 to 12.
You should have called it useless.
So 12, you got my nimble test. What's your nimble? D6?
Black rat, nimble. Yeah. D6. Yeah, 8, 6. Yeah.
So you might want 6, and then 6.
Yeah.
So nothing.
Okay, fucking.
You get one good roll, you really dodge it. First time he's shot anyone and actually hit properly, and it does nothing at all. That's from Shrew.
Shrew.
Onto it,
strike 6.
And it's the Sparrow, which is 4.
Oh, 2.
2, 3. And I got a shield because it's plus 1.
So. Yeah, so nothing.
Yeah.
Cool. So that's the end of that turn then, yeah?
Yeah, so it's just me again.
Okay, so Badger up next.
Oh, I've got to, but we're now on turn 4.
Yep.
I think, I might be turn 5, I've forgotten.
Yeah.
So Badger's attacking Toad. 8.
still laughing at Badger's attacking Toad.
Your block is probably 4, I
suppose. Yeah, 4.
And you get minuses a lot to this because you've got your minus 2, minus 5 to this?
4.
Minus but, 4.
Yeah, just minus 4.
Okay, and I've got plus 5, so my score is 13.
2.
2.
Is that going to kill me?
So you've got a score of minus 2, but only tough.
Tough 1.
So minus 1.
No, tough 2.
Tough 2. So basically you've got a score of 0.
Yeah.
Well, in terms of the wounds you'll take.
Yeah.
But you're going to take the team wounds.
So Toad's, Toad's dead.
Yeah.
Badger's Toad's pretty dead. Unstoppable. Cool. Okay, I've charged in my rat against the sparrow. Okay, so I'm D8 for my attack. So I've got an 8. Wow.
One. So you're minus 2 to that. I'm minus 1. So my score is 0 and you're minus 2. So your score is 8 plus 7.
15 minus...
Minus 2 for the charge.
Yeah.
Because the outnumber is the
box. Minus 2 for the charge,
skill.
Yeah.
So your 15 minus 2 is 13.
13.
So I would have 13 wounds, but I'm tough 1, so I have 12 wounds.
Wow. And you hadn't taken any before, had you?
Taken any before, yeah, no.
Okay, so... the sparrow is really low on health now, but it can just leave combat with no penalties, as far as we can see.
Yeah.
I did message ages ago when we first got the game and it came back that you never locked in combat.
Right.
So I don't see why you wouldn't just fly away now and just hide somewhere.
Yeah, because I can get so far away because I can move 16. So you're just going to fly, basically, over here.
Over there somewhere.
Yeah. I'll keep on tokens, I'll see him. There you go, hello.
So that's...
it's your shrew, basically.
Yeah, well, you might as well charge a badge with them. Otherwise... Because basically, so with charging, like this turn, I could just not charge and move closer so that I do... Do you see what I mean? Like, why would you not charge now?
Yeah. Yeah, because badges already
just, it's an extra attack, basically. Yeah. It's going to be not a very good attack. But
you might get a lucky roll. You might get your perfect roll.
So it'll be more than... Yeah, more than... Two.
Strike 6. So I only block 4.
Okay.
I'm tough. Lots.
Oh, 5.
5. So minus three. 2. So 3.
Yeah, so nothing. And you got your armor and everything. Yeah, cool.
Yep.
Is your thing shot yet?
No, he hasn't shot yet.
Shoot the rat then.
I don't think he shot yet. Yeah, I'm going to shoot the rat. So partial again. Because you're buying cover. So I'm minus 1 to this. 5, so 4. Which one nimble?
4. I think it's 6. Nimble. Yeah, 6.
6.
1. 1. Oh, no.
So you suffer 3 wounds.
No.
Yay, the Dormas did something.
And that means I've got a penalty now. Minus 1 penalty.
Not Dormas, so yeah, Dormas did something and the rat's got a penalty. Right, so that's the end of turn 4.
4, on to turn
quick
5.
Quick turns.
So, yeah, quite quick, especially because we're not using any advanced rules on magic.
We're not doing magic, we're not doing searching or hiding particularly, we're just kind of getting around combat really in the movement in this game.
Yeah.
And you can search buildings and things as well to find treasure, because you do run this as a campaign.
Yeah. I have to just start turn 5 and I've got half of my models left, so I have to take it. Like a route test, basically.
Yeah, and you roll your fortitude against my presence.
So my highest fortitude now without the cat is... Oh, the toad's fortitude 10.
Toad's dead.
Oh, shit.
Probably the rat, I assume.
The shrew's fortitude 8. The rat's only fortitude 6.
Really? The shrew's fortitude 8? Wow.
Yeah.
Malicious little shit.
Okay.
So my presence is 10. Basically, it's just a complete luck roll, man. You actually got a higher chance of getting a better roll, though.
Well, do you get the bonus to this if you
roll a perfect roll? Yeah. So every single roll you make?
No, one. You so one. Probably...
I rolled a 4.
Yeah.
And the game's over.
Cool. I actually really, really enjoyed it.
That was great fun.
I really like using different dice.
Yeah, interesting, because when I first read about the rules and about the penalties for charging, actually, because you don't fight a round of combat, you attack and they block and then they attack back. If you're charging someone who's already activated...
Yeah.
It doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
You must have to charge in because you might be shrewded.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, you didn't get the roll, but if you'd done that with the wildcat,
that
already activated.
Because in my wildcat, we didn't mention, but your heroes can take 2 skills. My wildcat had 2 really aggressive skills, like killing blow and fate. Never got to use them. Dan's skill came quite useful on the badger, which was no penalties for charging.
And no penalty if you didn't have a weapon.
Possibly like a no-brainer, possibly.
Well, I think with a really heavy combat model, it is.
Yeah. Badger's awesome.
Badger is awesome. The badger basically kill. I mean, did the sparrow do any? No, the squirrel did a couple of wounds to the toad, I think.
Yeah. The sparrow, the flying models could be really useful if you have magic and stuff.
Yeah, definitely. Although there is a penalty for casting and stuff when you do that.
Yeah.
But what I think I should have done with the sparrow is just move him last and just stick him behind you so that you're like, oh, there's now a sparrow right behind me. You know.
One thing I'm not sure of is you went first every time, which we agreed to do, but I think you probably should roll each time.
I think next time we'll, if we roll against each other's fortitude.
Because at one point you got to go the badger just twice in a row.
Basically, yeah, I did.
Which could still happen, but having that reliability.
Yeah, no one's going to happen is
that,
isn't it? That was a really fun game. There's something highly entertaining about going, the badger's hitting the toad.
The badger's caved the cat's head in with the club.
The squirrel just stabbed the cat in the back.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah,
really enjoyed that. And I can imagine with a campaign and like named heroes and everything, it's going to be really fun. So
definitely.
We'll try and get campaign going and play a few more battles at this. It's taken us ages to get around to doing it just because we've had so many other games that we've been playing and kept putting it off. But got our models painted up and...
Yeah, we've got nice scenery for this.
Yeah,
our old Warhammer scenery works really well for this kind of game. We've got plenty. We can do a 3x3 next time and do a proper game and with everything. So we're not gonna be doing the rolling on the injury tables or...
No, well, this is a smaller warband than you would take anyway.
Yeah, this is just for us to get a grip around the attacking really and the shooting and the movement.
Yeah.
And then next game we'll bring magic in and other stuff, I think.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Okay, well I hope you enjoyed that. I think we're probably like the only battle report for this game, but it's that we can see on YouTube. But it's actually really fun. And if you go to oathsworn miniatures.co.uk, is it?
.com.
I'll put a link in the description to the website and check out the miniatures. There's been some new ones either released recently or going to be released. And they're awesome, as like owls and all sorts.
Yeah, they're really good.
Yeah,
really, and what's really nice about them is they're all one piece.
Oh yeah! Oh my god, that was so nice.
Yeah, there's no gluing metal on them together.
They're all one piece, but they're not. You know, they're pretty.
They're very dynamic. One piece models. I mean, look at the badger.
Yeah, the badger
holding a huge club, and it looks really good. I mean, hands down to the guy who's done this, because he not only, I can't remember the guy's name is. I met him at Salute. He designs the models, casts them, and did all the rules. It's all just him. I think him and his wife, I think, that do everything for the game.
Amazing, really.
Yeah.
Yeah, really, really cool.
So,
this makes me want to get more of these miniatures as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've got two more I haven't painted yet.
Oh, have you?
So, yeah. Oh, cool. I've got another otter and a dog.
Oh, just get that mole up. The mole fryer. I just love that model. A mole fryer, look at that.
Also, there's something slightly wrong about this one though, because it's an otter with boobs.
Yeah, it's an awesome model. There's a really cool, I think, fox model, possibly, as well. Is it a fox with a bow? It just looks awesome.
Yes, there's a fox with a bow.
Yeah, cool. So we'll do some more of this in future, soon, I think.
Soon,
start a campaign. Cool. All right, well, thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next time.